she's a love that has laid hold of me. I'm holding on to the love that has laid hold of me.
Good morning to you, FCF. Hope you've had your first cup of coffee already. We're continuing a series about the analogy of running a race, that this life of staying in a trusting relationship with our Creator, it's likened unto running a race. It's a developmental journey, but it does take focus, it takes intentionality, it takes energy, it takes concentration, all these things. It means purpose. We're focused on God's purpose for our life every day, all the time, every circumstance. It's not a tense life, it's not a weird life, it's not a monastic life. It's as natural as breathing once you get in rhythm of it, but it is a race. It's not something that just happens without intentionality. You know, and I know, a human being will not grow, will not progress, will not become more Christ-like, will not expand in their virtues and in their capacities to think the way that God thinks and to love the way that God loves and to behave the way God behaves unless there is sufficient effort. We must know His word. We must know His will. We must have it inspire us, motivate us to do His word and His will. Then development happens. So we're keeping this analogy of a race going, and I'm going to read to you today from Psalm 119. Psalm 119 is a whopper. If you ever want to just read a psalm that will fill up some time, go ahead and read Psalm 119. You'll find an awful lot of verses in that one psalm. Psalm 119, and I'm going to read just one verse. The writer says, I run in the path of your commands, for you have set my heart free. I run in the path of your commands, for you have set my heart free. This is an interesting combination of ideas. Jesus said something a little bit similar to this in John chapter 8, verse 31 and 32. He said that, you know, if you continue in His word, then you will know the truth, and the truth will set you free. Continuing in His word sets you free. The psalmist says, I run in the path of your commands, for my heart has been set free. It's an interesting picture. We that live in modern times, we're used to seeing trains and train tracks. And the fascinating thing about a train is that as long as it stays on the rails, so picture the rails are the commands of God. The rails are the revelation of God of the way that He designed life to be lived by a human being made in His own image. The writer of Psalm 119 says, I run in the path of your commands. Picture that train. As long as that train stays on the rails, which are God's commands, His will, as it's revealed in His word, the train can go fast and it can go far. But if the train decides that it wants to be free from the will of God, does it gain freedom? Or does it in fact lose freedom? Well, the answer is clear. If it decides to leave the tracks, it doesn't gain freedom, perhaps for a short period of time as it's flying through the air or whatever the case may be, but it loses freedom forever. And so it is with us. God's commands are not arbitrary. He doesn't just get some sort of a strange enjoyment out of bossing us around. He lovingly instructs us in the way that He knows He designed us, because we're made in His own image. We have a God-given capacity to experience life on the rich level that God Himself does, but we won't unless we live the way God lives. Hence, He gives us His commands, because we're finite. We need to learn. We need to grow. When we embrace the commands of God, understanding they are the laws of liberty, it says in James, it says, embrace the law of liberty. God's commands liberate us. They don't restrict us. Well, then our heart indeed becomes set free. Jesus, you will know the truth. Truth will set you free. The writer of Psalms, let me read it to you one more time since it's so short. I run in the path of your commands, for you have set my heart free. That's the other thing we find. When we become habitually obedient to the word of God, the commands of God, when we feed our souls on the commands of God, we have to know His commands before we can run in them, which means to do them. We then discover something. Our heart becomes increasingly free. You might be thinking, Randy, what do you mean by that? Well, we start running in accord with God's commands. We start living in obedience to God's commands. Our conscience starts to feel very comfortable. We feel motivated. We feel an interior sense of harmony and well-being. We have a deepening sense of the approval of God, which is the only approval, folks, that you and I really need in this life or the life to come. And this frees our hearts. These hearts of ours are complex. They're made in the image of God. And until they are sufficiently liberated, and that liberation comes when we run in accord with God's commands, we can't even begin to understand the quality of life we have the capacity to experience. Listen, you probably heard me say a lot of times, it's not what happens to us in life that determines the quality of our life. It is what happens inside of us, not outside of us, that determines the quality of our life. When we run according to God's commands, our hearts become freer and freer. We have a sense of inner harmony, inner peace, enthusiasm, motivation, because something clicks and we start to realize, this is who I really am. This is who I was always meant to be. This is how life for everyone was meant to be lived. So how goes your run? Are you running according to God's commands this day? You got to know them first. You can't run in them until you know them. And there's only one way. You've got to study this wonderful, extraordinary book that we call the Bible. FCF, my wife told me not to wave at you, but I did it anyway. Goodbye for today. I'm holding on to the love that has laid hold of me. I'm holding on to the love that has laid hold of me.